the issues of police brutality. I mean, all issues that we have that's bringing injustice to the world, we want to present them at this march.
So this is a march that is for anyone who is concerned with justice. It's an everybody march.
Everybody march.
Okay, well, that solves that problem. So how are there organizations in Detroit who are expected to mobilize or to organize in order to get groups to
oh,
go?
Yes.
Are there, like,
we
buses?
Definitely want the think tank to get a bus.
Okay.
And bring people to the march. We have different organizations, Million Man Alumni, headed by Paul Taylor. Malik Shabazz, New Marcus Garvey Movement, many of the churches. Mm-hmm. In the community have already started reserving buses for this okay. event. Ray Wine and Ceasefire. I mean, I've talked to many who are already in the process of getting buses and getting people together to go to this event.
Okay. So who do we contact?
Right now, I'll give you my information.
Okay.
Which is 313-459-1909. That's Minister Troy Muhammad. That's 313-459-1909. And I want to give you another number, which is my protocol director. Her name is Maria Muhammad. And her number is 313-283-7245.
Okay, and if there's anyone who's tuning in who didn't get a chance to get the numbers or contact information, we're gonna make sure that we put everything on the Think Tank Facebook page. And also, do you have a website?
Not yet.
Okay. And while we're here, I see we have neglected to open up the phone lines. So please join the discussion. This is a discussion for everybody. And we're just gonna give you the call-in numbers. They're at the bottom of the screen, 313-868-0342, 313-868-0351, and 313-868-4336 to join the discussion with Student Minister Troy Muhammad. And dealing with the 1010. Now, what is the full title of the march again? Can you?
It's 101015.
Okay.
Justice or else.
101015. Justice or else, mm-hmm. And the else is up to us. Wonderful.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Because I mean, each individual you have as individuals, we have different
requirements, needs.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah.
And each mm-hmm. human being. I mean, we're so unique
mm-hmm.
and so different, just like our fingerprints.
Mm-hmm.
You know, justice for you may be different than justice for me.
Absolutely.
You know, what's required from you may be different. So all of this has to, you know, enter the conversation.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I think that's the goal of the minister and going around right now, because he's listening to our people to see what their thoughts are.
Mm-hmm. And that's something else. How can we as a people, as a community, be caught not knowing what our or else is?
Mm-hmm.
We are still looking around like, oh, what's the agenda?
Mm-hmm.
Let's find out.
Well, see, he can't or he doesn't want to determine that for you.
Mm-hmm.
He wants to make the call.
Mm-hmm.
He wants to bring those who are interested and who want justice together.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's up to them to determine what the or else is. If it's an economic boycott, that's or else.
Mm-hmm.
But it has to be based upon the people determining amongst themselves. As
mm-hmm.
I said, it's different looks in different cities. It's different experiences in different states. You know, so it would have to be looked at on an individual basis, on a you know, the unique of a Detroit, the uniqueness of a Chicago, the uniqueness of the black man in Idaho. You
mm-hmm.
know, his whole situation
Absolutely.
Is different than yours. So mm-hmm. we would have to look at everything.
Okay. Okay, yes. I wanted to ask you about the role of young people in coming together for this march. They have their own unique set of issues.
Mm-hmm.
So how would they be involved in the process?
Well, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan wants them involved totally. You're dealing with a different group of people when you talk about our young generation.
Mm-hmm.
He says this is our most beautiful generation, the most strong generation.
Okay.
However, they lack guidance.
Okay.
Our role is to give them guidance.
Mm-hmm.
The role of a Sutton Bay is to give young people guidance. The role of our organizations is not to exclude young people, but to give them guidance.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the minister has made it a very important point to meet with our rappers. If you've been following him, or if anyone's been following him, you've seen that he met with P. Diddy, Young Jeezy, Young Thug, a lot of the rappers from that community in Atlanta, Two Chainz. I think I've seen Brother Ice Cube. I mean, he's been meeting with all of the hip hop artists that he could, Snoop Dogg, everyone. And he'll be doing the same thing when he's here, meeting with our local hip hop artists as well, you know, and he wants to, at 83 years old, he wants to unload his experience
mm-hmm.
into the youth.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so the youth have a big role in this. The youth, he wants to help shape this agenda
mm-hmm.
because he says that it's all about the youth.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if we drop the ball as elders or as older people, you know, just imagine how history is going to write us down. You know,
absolutely. And it seems like, well, not seems like, I know that there was a time when the youth were the ones who were bringing about change.
Mm-hmm.
They were the ones who were at the forefront of the movement for apartheid. Those were children,
mm-hmm.
you know, in Soweto, the civil rights movement 50 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Basically children, you know, very young people.
Yes. When Malcolm X joined the nation, he was in his 20s.
Mm-hmm.
Dr. King started in his late teens.
Okay.
The new Black Panther Party, these were all young people in their 20s and their teens.
Sure were.
So it was, you know, it was always the youth that mm-hmm. were starting the movement, you
mm-hmm.
know. And this is probably the only generation in which it's different,
mm-hmm.
you know. They're strong in the aspect that you see, like in the hip-hop community, the entrepreneurism.
Okay.
You know, though they're making wiser decisions in those areas,
mm-hmm.
but not so wise decisions in other areas. And that's where the guidance comes in at. And
okay.
that shows you the type of how special they are.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're going into a corporate world now. They're taking control of corporate worlds. These are young men and women. You know, and then they come and then they employ hundreds of
okay.
people, young people who look just like them.
Okay.
So they, it's there,
it just
but
looks
it has
different.
To be tweaked.
Okay.
In a lot of ways, because,
okay.
I mean, you can't build your empire off of insulting your people.
Absolutely.
Or demonstrating a level of self-hatred.
Absolutely.
Or degrading your women.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so they show that they have the talent to produce and to move the world, because this music isn't just being consumed by Black children in America, but it's mostly consumed by white children in America. And then if you go to other countries,
mm-hmm.
it's all over the place. So we've demonstrated, our young men and women have demonstrated an ability to produce businesses and to employ our people, but
mm-hmm.
they just need some guidance.
So I think that they're in a unique position to be able to affect what our image is worldwide,
mm-hmm.
because we're in a global world now.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is global, so everything that they do, someone is looking. You know, it can
all
be
right.
the smallest thing. We have all these social media platforms. We have YouTube. So I think one of the things that I would like for us to keep in mind is that the world is watching us,
mm-hmm.
and the youth especially need to understand that. I was actually having a conversation with a group of young ladies, and somehow there was some reference to, I'm sorry, it's a TV show. It's a very popular TV show. It's a very popular TV show.
Empire,
so sorry, brain fart. They asked me if I watched Empire. They were making some reference to it. They said, oh, Mom Tyrion, do you watch that? And I said, you know what? I'm aware that there is a show on television called Empire, but I haven't seen it. I'm aware of what it's about, but I'm not supporting it because we need to be responsible as viewers and not support things that make us look a certain way to the rest of the world. You know, we have to protect our image worldwide, and Empire does not help us do that. So that's just something that, you know, I like to remind the young people that we need to be responsible for our image within our community and in the greater world community, which is something that you talked about that the Million Man March did.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a call. Okay, it no, is Brother just, Bay, yes.
It's just me. I'm just listening. I definitely agree with what you just said about Empire. I'm not going to say anything against what you just said because it makes a lot of sense, especially not just with that. You have Love and Hip Hop. You have a lot of different other programs that's out there that I watch as well. And I watch them for the purpose of being able to extract certain things from there and utilize it for ministerial purpose or for mm-hmm. my ministry.
Mm-hmm.
So I have a different approach to why I watch it, because it also gives me an understanding of what it is that they're programming our young people or just people in general to think and to embrace.
Decoding.
You're
decoding.
Yeah, that's exactly a good word to use.
Mm-hmm.
So the thing that I want to get back to and I want to point out is that I remember when we had the Million Man March the first time,
mm-hmm.
and I was incarcerated up north in the UP, and the Caucasians up there gave us that day as a holiday. They allowed us to fast. They gave us bag lunches. Every television was on it. We was watching it, and it was a big thing. And what I took from it, or what I didn't like that a lot of brothers and sisters did 5 years down the line, is they criticized what didn't come of the Million Man March. And what I wanted to say to a lot of brothers and sisters that's listening is that those of you who had a lot of things to criticize about what Farrakhan didn't seize, what opportunities he didn't seize, or what got past us, well, now the opportunity is before you or before us again. And when this 10-10-15 happens, I don't want nobody to talk about what Farrakhan didn't do or what Farrakhan didn't say. I want you to ask yourself, what is it that you're going to do? And what is it that you're going to say? Because this is the same thing you should have been coming out of your mouth after the first Million Man March, is what is it that you didn't do? And what is it that you didn't say? See, he lit the fire to give us this fuel or to give us this energy to go back into our communities and do the things that you think that he could have done or should have done. He can't do everything. And don't expect for the Nation of Islam to do everything. Just utilize that energy to catapult your ideas of positivity to the next level. Because it's going to be up before us again. So if we don't allow ourselves to do that and we just want to run around and talk about what he didn't do and what he could have done, then all you want to do is just be a whiner. And you just want to complain. And you might as well just shut up and just go get you somewhere to sit down and just be quiet and get out the way. And let those of us who want to do the work, do the work. Because the work is only going to get done by those who do the work. So if you really want to be the force that you know we are and what our forefathers were, then we have to look towards ants. look towards bumblebees. Look in nature, and you look at everybody else, and all that is in nature. A lot of brothers and sisters that I build with over the years like to say, everything in nature submits its will to Allah but us. The ants is doing what they're supposed to do. The bumblebees is doing what they're supposed to do, but they work as a collective whole. You know, we look at the birds when they fly around in the dirt and they wash themselves off in the little dirt, and then they turn around. Brothers say, well, the bird is getting ready to go make salat. Brother, he's doing wudu. Prophet Muhammad told him, you don't have no water to wash yourself off with the dirt or the sand. And so the metaphor that I'm trying to point out to you is, if you don't know how to do it, look to something that you think is lesser of you and let it show you how to do it. Humble yourself, because the bumblebees and the ants, they work as a collective unit. Everybody has their own responsibility and their own job to make sure that particular part of their life or their existence is productive. And that's what we must do as a people.
Yes, sir. I want to add to that concerning the Million Man March and the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan, what he didn't do. You know, when I came across the minister, I was in prison, and I was serving 25 to 50 years. I was a young man who didn't care much about himself or anybody else for that matter. So I sold drugs, I shot, I got shot. You know, I wasn't a person really concerned or who loved myself or anybody who looked like me. And the minister's words came into my life at the right time, and I was able to see him at the right time, and I saw a black man like no other that I'd ever seen. And once I processed what I was looking at, my life was changed. And it was based upon me deciding to change it. The minister comes in front of us and he gives us a word. He gives us guidance. And then it's up to us to take the word, to take the guidance, and apply that guidance to ourselves. Take that word, apply it to ourselves. Jesus in the church, he can't do anything for the church members. He can only do what the church members apply. So you can look at Jesus, you can look at Moses, you can look at Muhammad and say, well, what did they do? But their job as messengers is just to present a word. It's up to us to take the word. So he was used by God to call us to Washington, D.C. so that we can see ourselves in a different light. That was all he needed to do. But we constantly, because we hate ourselves, we're looking for something else. We're looking for some type of handout. We're looking for people to do for us what we have the potential and power to do for ourselves, man.
That's right.
Each of us, just like the minister, and he's never separated himself from us. He always, when I go to his home and I sit with him and talk with him, he always talks about not himself, but he talks about our potential to do. How's the brothers and sisters in Detroit? You know, he came here and he talked to us a couple years ago about going out and buying these homes that were, you know, you can get home for $100, $200. Mm-hmm. He gave us good advice, good guidance. But we didn't go out and do it. So now you have young Caucasians coming in the city buying up homes, while we still homeless, looking crazy. The job of the messenger is to present the word. And that's what he did. Now it's time for us to do something. It's time for you to look at the man or woman in the mirror and say, I'm going to do something. That's the bottom line. That's why the Quran says no bearer of a burden can bear another's burden. It's on you, man.
That's right.
The Bible talks about how he'll take one and leave one in the same bed. Because the wife can't do it for the husband and the husband can't do it for the wife. Ye are all God's children of the Most High God. That's what the scripture says. But then after that, it talks about how since we won't recognize that we are children of the Most High God, we're going to die like men.
That's right, brother. And that's what I drew from in here, because I had to stop myself from saying what I couldn't get done or giving myself the excuses why this couldn't happen. And I had to say, well, dang, man, if all of these messengers is coming to me telling me that we are gods, and it's saying in the scripture that we are gods, children of the Most High. Noble Drew Ali taught us that, you know, wisdom is the consciousness that man is God, that Allah and man are one. And we already know what the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad taught us about the black man being God.
And it's the same thing when you say time never was when man was not. I mean, that's all the same thing, man.
That's right. So we have to tap into that. In order for me to say that I bear witness that it's true, I had to apply those teachings to myself and see what manifested from that. And what manifested from that was two books that I authored and my wife published through her publishing company, Song Jazz Productions. This platform that we have right here today, married a beautiful wife who was an MGT, who I would never encourage or even try to take from the Nation of Islam ever, because I know that that is what makes us strong. The fact that she's a part of the Nation of Islam in the ranks of the MGTs, and I'm a member of the Board of Science Temple of America. You know, these are the things that we bring to the table and figure out how can it be beneficial to our people instead of bickering about, well, I don't believe that I'm black, or I don't believe that I'm da-da-da-da-da. Those are frivolous arguments that we use to hold ourselves back. See, Willie Lynch, it's not just in the mind of, I don't like you because you light-skinned, or you dark-skinned, or you tall, or you short. Willie Lynch is everywhere, economically, socially, religiously, politically. It is everywhere within the fiber of our people. And anywhere we see Willie Lynch, we must stomp him out. And because I use Willie Lynch to say this is the reason why I don't want to unite with Brother Farrakhan, you got to stomp that out. Because you need to find what you do agree with Brother Farrakhan and utilize that to the benefit of our people. Because we're not going to all agree on everything.
Yeah, but I mean, the funny thing is that that same brother or sister, they'll shop at Walmart, you know, or they'll eat at McDonald's, you know, and they would never ask, well, who's the owner? And what don't I agree with the owner about, you know?
Mm-hmm. Oh, well, no, you know, we only boycott our own.
Right,
that's
who produces Nike? Why, you know, I do disagree with him. You know, we don't do that. Mm-hmm. And it speaks towards a self-hatred, man. That is so upsetting. And this is why the minister recently said, we look foolish going to Washington, D.C., asking government for justice.
I'm about to step out on y'all. I got to go. But before I go, I'm going to let you and Sister Terry close it out. But before I go, I want brothers and sisters to know that I'm supporting Enough Said. Enough Said is an acronym for Enough Sexual Assault in Detroit. Was unveiled by our prosecutor, Ms. Kim Worthy. Y'all brothers can say what y'all want to say about me. I'm coming home to be something that I've never been before, and that's a citizen to the community that I'm from, the citizens of the community that I was a parasite of, people that look like me. And the only way that I can do that is by supporting what's right. Enough Said, Enough Sexual Assault in Detroit. Y'all go check that out and get in where you fit in. Peace, brother. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
So that, I don't know if that was a website, but that was, again, Enough Sexual Assault in Detroit. I'm definitely going to Google that when I get a chance. So can you give us, again, the contact information?
Okay. 313-459-1909. You can call. That's my number. Call that, and then I'll hook you up with the appropriate parties. And I want to close by saying that the minister says that you know, in order to go to Washington, D.C. and demand justice, we have to first be just to one another and just to ourselves. We have to be just to our brothers and sisters. We have to be just to our family members. We have to be just to the members of our community, or we look foolish trying to ask somebody to give us justice when we're not giving justice to one another or justice to ourselves. So let's start the charity at home. Let's start ending the beefs that we have at home. Let's start treating each other right and talking to one another in the right tone and loving on one another. Let's be just to one another so that we come as a united front demanding justice or else in Washington, D.C.